And now for our 90 kilogram championship bout. Fighting out of the blue corner, weighing in at 88 kilograms, a brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, fighting out of New Zealand, B-Team and Mana Grappling, Kai Rudolph! And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, weighing in at 87.7 kilograms, a brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, fighting out of Australia, Gracie Baja Bondi, Ricky Pachon!
And we are about to get underway. 90 kilo championship belt battleground on the line. I am excited for this matchup.
I'm super excited too. I've known Kaya since similar time to Tito, 16, 17. And he has grown into a phenomenal competitor and very good young man.
Yeah, both men really respectful of each other in the build up to this fight. They've studied each other intensely.
I believe they're friends.
Yeah, they are friends, yeah. You could tell from the way they were talking to each other. Both aware of each other's strengths and weaknesses and both looking to exact the game on them. Both, I think, are coming into this. They were coy on the game plan, but I think both of them have got a very specific plan for each other. Just sizing each other up, feeling each other out at the moment in time.
Absolutely. I haven't actually seen Ricky compete, but I've heard he's very, very tough and very, very hard to submit. He's a very durable athlete.
Yeah, he was, you know, you listen to him talk on the phone, you were on the over teleconference, it was interesting because you would never think, you know, the way he talks, the way he puts himself across, that this is an absolute killer on the mats, you know. Super nice guy, super chill.
Almost I saw him in the change rooms, like, dancing and, like, being a little menacing.
Almost nerdy, you know what I mean, but, like, absolute killer on the mats and really interesting. Now we just look at a single leg attempt, Kai defends. Interesting collar
tie. Very nice with the grip fights.
Yeah.
And bringing his hands and shoulders forwards.
So smooth and so languid in terms of what they're doing. But both men aware that those controls are absolutely going to be the key to dictating this matchup.
Yeah, a really like beautiful thing about watching Kai compete as well is that his dad is always in his corner. I mean, my dad doesn't do jiu-jitsu. To my knowledge, he loves me, but not that much.
Not as much as Kai Rudolph's dad loves him. Oh, no, and having that support, you know, and having someone like there for you when you look up and you see there, you know, makes you want to compete, makes you want to work. And that's whatever you take whatever motivation you can get in these kind of matches, you know.
Oh, Ricky reaching for the leg. I'm always really skeptical when I see someone reach. I feel like that's like an opportunity for some flying submission or something.
You're not setting it up. You know,
similar to what you're saying with the prelims, with the setting up.
Yeah, you know, you've got to say, you know, especially against really, really skilled opponents, you know, if you're just reaching for that leg, you're asking for trouble, you know what I mean?
Definitely.
You've got to set up your attempts. Both men standing high, both men looking for those clinch controls. I want to
see. Very nice.
Ricky
very
picks
nice.
The leg up again. That was a little bit better, wasn't it? He'd engage the upper controls and then drop quickly.
And the head positioning, the off balance. Yeah. That's usually like, I see so many single legs where people grab the leg and they stop moving. You know, like the key to a good single leg is to follow through no matter what move is next. As long as it's off balancing, it's going to be more positive than grabbing the leg and standing there.
Yeah, you know, the thing is when you pick up the leg, it's not going to get you the takedown. What you actually have to do is off balance your opponent. You have to be able to bring that leg to a position he doesn't want it to be and then use it to offsuit their structure. When you can unbalance the structure, that's where you can open up opportunities, whether that's guard pull, whether it's attacking.
Very nice arm drag.
Beautiful arm drag. It's attacking, whether it's basically looking for the takedown, it gives you those options to do so. But when you remain static, it actually gives your opponent a chance to counter.
I wonder how much these two boys have trained with each other. Obviously, they're friends, like we were mentioning before. Sometimes when it comes to somebody that you've trained with so much, you guys know what to like be wary of, and sometimes not a lot can happen. Yeah. I'm hoping there's sparks within this match, and I feel like from meeting them both, they both want to definitely get the dub, and they both want to like go for it and
absolutely
go hard.
The thing to remember with this one is it is a 20-minute matchup, you know, so we're in that opening stage of the match. We're not, but the match has still got 5 minutes in, so you know, what we're going to see is at one point one of these guys is going to increase the pace, you know, and it looks to me as if Kai is just starting to get a bit of a feel for how he wants to attack. He's starting up looking to get that shoulder clamp working there.
Kai is spending a lot of time at B team. Obviously they're very big on standing up with the feet and wrestling into good positions. Kaya has competed all over the world. I've I've literally seen him compete since he was a kid, and
yeah.
It's so nice to see him grow into this man that competes at like the main event of a show.
Well, he's 22 years old, you know what I mean? He's got an amazing, you know, hopefully all being well, another 10, 15 years ahead of him at the highest level, you know, and that's what you want to be doing, you know. This sport is a sport where injuries can play a part, but, you know, if you can keep fit, beautiful snap
Excellent
down.
Excellent snap.
Beautiful that's snap down.
Very nice chin strap he's
yeah,
got.
I want to see a sprawl from here. I want to, yeah, and we're getting a little bit of a sprawl.
At least tire the opponent
Yeah,
out.
just make him carry your weight. Just make him work a little bit. Good catch there now by Ricky.
Is excellent from this position. Yeah, if you can get behind yeah. him. So flexible and mobile. Ricky, though, with the leg pick.
Yeah, the leg pick was crucial there. So Kai didn't beat the arms. He didn't clear the arms, which meant that Ricky just had an opportunity to reach, and he did reach, and he was able to counter there. Brilliant work from
Kai
Ricky.
Kai now with the flexible reverse del Hivo into an inversion into 50-50.
Yeah.
I remember when Kai was doing this with Lachlan back in the day. It was like his little prodigy. Because of how flexible he is.
So talk through where this position leads if you're able to successfully transition.
50 to the heel, which is, it looks like he just had the bar on the heel, but
yeah,
the knee was free.
Ricky drives,
Ricky.
Great
yeah, Ricky
takedown.
Chasing it.
Great takedown.
He definitely wants to stay on top against somebody like Kaya. Yeah. That said though, Kaya's entries from the bottom and how bendy he is, how flexible he is, mobile, it's a problem. This here is the false reap position.
Yeah. And Ricky needed that takedown there. You know, Kai was actually in a pretty good position, you know, to attack from there. And that takedown's just changed the flow of the fight. And now Ricky's on the attack. You're right. I can see that flexibility starting
He's
to come into play.
He's incredibly flexible.
Starting to come into play already. You know, and
it's
that
like incredibly gumby for somebody that's quite thick.
Yeah, with that leg being in the way, you know, that enables him to start to bring his quads into play and start to isolate Ricky's legs, start to pull it away, you know, and that's, you know.
This just looks like a cheat code. My knee would blow up doing that.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
In fact, it has.
Yeah. You know, once you reach the age of 30 plus, then your knees change from being made of flesh to cheese.
I swear that started happening to me at 25.
mine came late. It came at 35, but now, knees are officially made of cheese. But that's okay. We work with what we've got. And Ricky just looking to progress his pass. Both men working technically, fighting the controls.
This position is exactly where most LCL injuries happen with that reap.
Yeah,
trying to force it. But he didn't have his feet locked and he didn't obviously have that pressure through.
Yeah.
Kai being a smart like competitor and knowing where his body can go is obviously the intuition here for that kind of guard retention.
I'm intrigued by the pace of this. You know, it's constant, but it hasn't reached fever pitch yet. You know, both men still operating at a languid pace, smooth pace, good controls by Ricky on the feet, just stopping Alex playing his game.
Definitely.
Kai playing his game, sorry.
I think in regards to how long the match is, definitely staying on top and pounding is definitely a way to outmaneuver your opponent in the long run.
Yeah.
That said though, Kai seems to be just incredibly mobile and very relaxed in these scenarios. Now he's got an actual entry. His right leg's stuck, but he's going to choose to come up with it instead of the 50-50 entry.
I don't think people could appreciate how beautiful that was. That was absolutely
a very nice kiss of the dragon sort of style.
Very nice, very very smooth technical transition there. And Kai Ricky did a really good job of defending that and coming away. He recognised there was a bit of a threat there and disengaged, and it was great disengagement. And I like the fact that even though the pals, Ricky isn't actually scared of being aggressive in the taxis. You know, he's certainly looking to push away when he feels like he needs to. He's not making any excuses about that.
No, he's game. He's a game opponent.
Yeah, very game indeed. Both men just sizing each other up. And I reckon there's a chance this might go the distance. Just from the way they're giving each other that respect. I'm going to see it slowly ramping up with the speed and intensity, I think. But both
there's
men are well matched.
There's a very nice way to get to a far hip grip.
Ricky just managed to right himself up there and reshape his body rather than being side on. And, you know, if he'd just had space to run to side on, he would have finished that takedown with the front headlock.
He's done that front headlock again.
Yeah, great position. Slow, languid snap down, but a good snap down.
Now, is Kai going to make the same mistake and rush towards the back?
I don't think so. He's going to put that on. That's on. That is on. That is high. Beautiful.
Ricky throwing his hips at it.
He did indeed. Oh, no, saying it wasn't there. Right smile from both men.
Out of everything that counts, right? The eyes of the judges.
Absolutely. And let me tell you, saying it wasn't there, but the way he defended it tells me it was.
I'm really liking how these two athletes are moving.
Yeah. Super controlled, but, you know, there's intention behind everything they're doing. You know, and that's when you know the people at the top of the game.
I feel like these Monster energy drinks are finally wearing off on me.
Oh, you're starting to level out a little bit.
I was very wired before. I had like three. I was flying.
Yeah. I don't know whether it was that or when the milkman picked you up. Oh, body lock, good body
maybe
lock.
Maybe it was a fight of flight.
Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful takedown with the body lock.
Beautiful. And the tempo was just increased. Kai Rudolph on the attack.
Potential back takes here, but...
Yeah, some instruction from his father
Ricky
in the corner.
Ricky with the kicking to stand up.
Very smart to get up quickly.
Yeah, got to be a little bit careful.
Well, not kick, but
yeah,
got to
be a little bit careful there, yeah.
I don't think he was kicking hard enough to
warrant
the kick,
really,
but yeah.
But, you know, yeah, you never know with the referees, do you? Yeah. You never know.
Yeah, let's hope there's no, like, disqualifications
yeah,
in this match.
That would be yeah.
That was
beautiful. Beautiful counter. Beautiful
to get behind
counter.
Him.
Alex Duren.
Look at how bendy Kaya yeah. is to maneuver, but so Ricky. But
yeah.
So is Ricky's upper back to invert
yeah,
this way.
Absolutely. Ricky did really, really well there defending that leg. That leg was coming round, sweeping in, and Ricky was just able to stop it, and he's doing this great job now of just defending. Oh, and now we find ourselves in a crucifix position.
Ricky being very tactical with like yeah. with where he's putting himself to not yeah. let Kaya settle into the position.
Yeah.
He does have to watch a guillotine if he
yeah,
sits
he
in
does.
There.
Yeah, he does. You're absolutely right. Some good instruction coming from his corner right now. Father telling him to tell Kaya to take north, south, and then move forward from there.
And then
he's looking for that guillotine. He's looking to get that
head.
He's got a head. He's got the head that tight. He managed Ricky manages to break out. Beautiful work and stop. And then move back to centre. Adam Metcalf.
Blood.
Got a slight bit of blood right now.
Potential
we'll just have
blood.
A short break for a second. Quick check from the doctor.
Look, I mean, I did say that everything I heard about Ricky was that he was a hard guy to tap.
Yeah, so yeah. Well, you know, that was on, but Ricky did a really, really good job. And he's just in the middle of the ring now, just calming himself down, just resettling his breathing. Really smart. Very halfway through.
Kaya draws a little blood,
yeah.
but the doctor says it's all good.
Yeah. About halfway through a really absorbing technical matchup and getting thrilling, really, I would say, Mikel.
Yeah, I feel like they're finally starting to open up a bit more and,
yeah.
and start to attack. Kaya with like the better attack so far, but honestly very impressed with Ricky's composure and the defensive stance
yeah.
and not taking too many risks and baiting
yeah.
Kaya to go for things
yeah.
and then getting out.
Yeah, I think Kaya's going to get more opportunities, but I think Ricky's going to get one, and that's going to be really interesting when Ricky gets his attack. That
yep.
front headlock position proven really successful for Ricky.
Starts to get tiring as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Sorry, really successful Kaya. Ricky is just, you know, starting to wear him down a little bit. Looking for it again. Interesting that he's using that goose grip a lot. Like not so much of a proper traditional collar tie, but almost like a goose grip collar
yeah.
tie.
Yeah, from training with Kaya and rolling with him, he is naturally very efficient with
yeah.
how he uses his
yeah,
body, and he's always
that.
Been the same. Like, he's not a weak individual by any chance, but he'll never feel strong unless he has to.
No, no,
and
absolutely.
That's always a strong gift in jiu-jitsu, I think.
Yeah, double or no attempt.
Because you can get anyone in jiu-jitsu and they're going to feel strong
yeah.
in the first 30 seconds. It's just
yeah.
a matter of
absolutely.
How you deal with that afterwards.
A stop, yeah, good stop by the referee there. And we set back into the middle and we're back on the way. Kaya looking for that, you know, almost head and shoulder clamp, you know. Good snap down.
Incredibly good timing with that snap
yeah,
down.
Absolutely.
Ricky
yeah.
needs to start addressing that collar tie a bit better. Maybe hand fight to stop Kaya from grabbing
yeah.
the head. And it seems like he's adjusting to that now, but he can't
yeah.
let Kaya hang off his head.
Yeah, he was a bit too comfortable with it, wasn't he? He was almost allowing and accepting that position.
I think it just starts to wear
yeah,
a little too
absolutely.
Much.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it does wear, you're absolutely right. It tires you down over time, you know, with your head being constantly pulled down because it's pulling on your spine, you know what I mean? It's pulling on your head and your spine. And
yeah.
that's tiring.
And once that starts to get tired, a lot of the body starts to get tired.
Absolutely. And I think Ricky, you know, Kaya certainly had his offensive moments here, and I think Ricky needs to be starting to think about impressing his own offensive game on Kaya, because at the moment it's, you know, a lot of defending that's going on for him at the moment in time. He's living with Ricky, he's living with Kaya, but he hasn't been able to get his offense on the go as of yet.
Not yet, at least. Hopefully he starts to take
time.
A bit more risks.
We've still got time. That's exactly right. Beautiful
Very
trip.
Nice lap
Beautiful
drop.
Trip. Stopped again. Referee stops it just before we run off the mat.
That might have been his opportunity to attack a leg.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm going to reset and come back to stand. Another good trip from Kai Rudolph. fighting for 2-1 on control.
Yeah, Ricky's fighting the 2-1, but I think that collar tie is the thing he's got to deal with the most. Yeah, in my opinion, anyway.
Yeah, that goose.
Like that. Yeah. That seems like it's that goose not grip. A fun scenario to be a part of.
That goose grip he's using over and over again. I mean, what options, Mikhail, from that position? If someone's doing that to you, what options have you got from there?
So there's throw-by options if you had your own gooseneck. I actually like to flare the elbow. Like, I'm a big fan of, like, the fireman's carries or the high crotch sort of style. So absolutely. Shooting with the inside hand instead of the outside hand.
Yeah.
That's typically what I would try and do from there. And Ricky manages to get him down with almost like an ankle pick sort of style.
Good
single
takedown.
Leg.
Good takedown. He needed that, I think.
I think so. I think he needs to stay on top.
Yeah, he really does.
To work higher out.
Again, easier said than done when you've got someone as flexible as Kai Rudolph on the attack.
And also, the takedown's not meaning as much as other things in this rule set.
Absolutely, yeah. The thing is, with Kai, you can just see he's just super, super comfortable from that position. He's not in any threat or danger whatsoever. You know, he's
absolutely
able
not.
To regard at a moment's notice. You know, these kids are the future. These are the kids that are, you know, are going to be taking over. We're going to be seeing at ADCC in the next couple of years because their ability to move their bodies and be good everywhere is just unbelievable. Front headlock, body lock position. He's got that
now. He has the arm in.
Yeah, he does. He's he moves. Oh,
heading
beautiful.
Towards the stack. Can he get behind the arm before jumping on the back?
Ricky's
that right arm has stopped Kai in his tracks every single time.
Yeah, Ricky's head's just popped up here. He's going to move. If he's going to move, he's going to move shortly because Kai is going to progress his position and put him under a threat of a submission here. And there we go.
It's a live by the sword, die by the sword escape. You know, I love doing that escape as well, but there's a chance that when somebody does take you back, your arm's stuck.
Absolutely, absolutely. But this position right now, not moving, you know, it doesn't lead to good things. Does not lead to good things. Doesn't matter how good you are, staying in this position does not lead to good things.
And it also doesn't look the best in the eyes of the judges.
No, absolutely right. You know, you're on the offensive. He's just looking to pull Kai's leg
through.
It's
that right arm. The right arm, again, is his success to his defense, to getting his back taken.
Absolutely.
Very, very impressive, like, defensively by Ricky.
Ricky did
he's
well.
He's done a great job to deny him with just that right arm every time.
Ricky did well. Really, really well. He's just got to shoot it out. He shoots it out, you know, with speed.
There's a smother attempt.
Yeah, we've seen a bit of the Tito Kale school of defense.
That was such a wild match before.
It was a wild match. It was, you know, it had everything really, you know, everything you want from a jiu-jitsu match. You know, Tito really pulled it out the bag there. It shows that you should never give up until the fight's over.
Absolutely,
you know,
not.
You've always got a chance. Oh, beautiful work. Beautiful work from Kai Rudolph. You appreciate what he's doing there. You know, almost a quasi-body lock, but also with the leg included and a jump
he
over.
Moves so well.
I know,
the right arm
so
again. The right arm again of Ricky stopping him in his tracks.
And like, Mikhail, talk us to, you've got a couple of ideas myself here now you beat that, but how would you beat that arm? What would you be
I
doing
would
here?
Instead of going for the chin strap and the front headlock, I'd go for the 100% style. So with the right arm, I'd go into the underhook and I'd use my left hand to go in front of their shoulder just so I can kind of separate their knee from their elbow and stop them from sitting down in a position like this.
Yeah.
Kind of chest it a bit better. One. Yeah. The other option is what we saw with Pablo with the Peruvian necktie.
Absolutely.
That's the other option there.
So from an MMA position, what I'd probably be doing is looking to snap the arm across, beat it at the tricep, and then look to pass around, and then from there look to punch my
punish.
Hand through and take
punish.
The back. Yeah.
Punish from
you know,
an MMA standpoint.
Yeah, absolutely.
But he's made it behind now, Kyle.
Yeah.
And Ricky's definitely got a be strategic in regards to his defense. He can't tripod because it gives him the space, but it seems like he needs Kai to fall off. It looks like Kai has double underhooks. I can't tell if it's a seatbelt.
I'd normally be pretty comfortable with someone being that high, but Kai Rudolph is so flexible. He's so flexible that I'd be massively concerned.
He's got the second hook. Kai needs to block the hand and deal with the underhook side. Ricky's right arm is his success right now with his defense.
He's defended incredibly well, but Kai is taking the back now, and we've got time to go. He's going to look to extend them out.
He's pulled that hand through like we're talking about with the back attacks before. Kai has the possibility with just face choking him with the right hand right now if he can free it.
Kai, and Ricky's done a really good job of defending here from having his back fully taken to now.
He wants
Kai
to go towards the mount.
Yeah,
Kai is
absolutely.
Not
he's not
and there we
back.
Have the feet crossed on the back with the potential seatbelt and choke, but Ricky manages to rotate his hips to face the ground. If I was Kai right now, I'd probably try and stretch him out. I'm just not sure if Ricky is going to accept that.
Yeah, and I would be absolutely looking to do the same thing. I'd be looking because Ricky's ability to manipulate his body comes all from his spine. So you've got to take that out of the equation. You've got to disconnect his power. You know, take away his ability to move so effectively. And you can do that in some crude ways, but, you know, for sure, right now, Kai is in a promising position and he's got a couple of options up to him. About 5 minutes left of the match.
5 minutes left. Kai on the back, looking very good. Is he able to secure the back? and potentially get a submission? That's the next question.
Yeah, I mean, right now I can only score this for Kaya, but as we saw with the last fight, I was only scoring it for Alex, yeah. And you know, Tito pulled off the submission at the last minute, so 100%. Anything can happen.
That's the beauty of combat sport.
Absolutely, it is. You've always got a chance.
Oh, does he have the choke there?
Looked like he got underneath the neck a little bit. Ricky recovers.
He's settling for positional.
Yeah.
Ricky is incredibly good at clearing and then baiting, almost a mount-esque scenario.
Yeah, I'm incredibly impressed by Ricky's ability to...
Oh, does Kai have, I think Kai has
deep,
it.
That's deep. That it looks to me as if it's in. He flattens him out. He's underneath the neck. He may get the finish here. We may crown ourselves an under 90 kilograms title winner. Ricky is fighting well. Ricky's holding on for dear life. He's trying to clear the hooks. Can he clear? Can he get up? And he does. Beautiful escape from Ricky Paixón.
Does he get tapped? Oh, he's in a guillotine. Inverted north-south.
Beautiful work by Ricky Paixón. He has managed to escape from near death.
And he is feeling the fire from that as well. Look at how much he's ramped up. He's ready to go.
Mikhail, talk us through that exchange.
He was on the verge of death and he survived.
I would have to agree with that.
I think that was an excellent submission. He was being face choked while his hips were on the ground, so there's a slight neck crank there as well. He managed to get his head on the mat, which forced Kai to let go. And then he was in a guillotine and Kai didn't follow through, luckily enough for him. And then he just found his fire for a bit, hounded the guard, and now he's hounding with his guard to get on top to a better position.
Yeah. He just does all the right things, doesn't he, Ricky Paixón? You know, when you're in a bad position, he does all the technically correct things to do to move towards and escape.
I would say it's technically very sound, his defenses.
Oh, Ricky there. Ricky with his first offensive moment. And that looked dangerous to me. That looked like that was deep.
I wonder if Kaya's getting tired.
Yeah, maybe it'll be. And Ricky's on the offensive now. Grabs the ankle.
That right arm.
And gets the takedown.
Oh.
Steps over. On the attack, he's got the leg. The leg is secure.
Is Kai able to free his knee line? Is this going to be a leg lock shootout?
And he has the leg. He has the leg.
Straight foot lock.
90 seconds left. Ricky knows he has to push the face. He has to push the face if he wants to win this match. He's got to get something going on Kaya Rudolph, who's shown control throughout the matchup.
Excellent match.
Beautiful matchup. Again, a beautiful match. This matchup from the Battleground guys. Great work in terms of finding out the people who are at a level and bringing them together for what have been absolutely fire matchups. Does Kai have another push in him?
Does he?
You would hope so, but Ricky's doing
Ricky's
well.
On the offense now.
He is on the
Kai
offensive.
Could take his back from here, but Ricky could also leg lock him.
He's got to stretch that leg out and bring
Kai
his
a
arms
hard
through.
Guy. Look at his hips right now. A very hard guy to foot lock until the rotation will be.
And Ricky's
live.
Got that leg. Can he isolate it?
Kai with maybe a bite of his own, potentially.
Yeah, both men exchanging leg locks right on the edge here. And the match is over.
Great match.
What a match from Kai Rudolph and Ricky Paixón.
Ricky Paixón, unkillable.
Absolutely unkillable. Brilliant work by both men. We will be moving to judge's decision very shortly. And I cannot wait to find out who is our under 90 kilogram champion. I've been Daniel Pini. I've been here with my man, Mikhail Yahar. That has been an amazing show, and we're not done yet.
What a phenomenal show so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of our 90 kilogram championship belt, and you, fighting out of the blue corner, Kai Rudolph.
with Ricky. Ricky, what a performance. You've been deemed in the commentary box as unkillable. How do you feel about your performance today?
Unkillable, guys, let me tell you that. No, it was a good performance. I'm happy with what I worked on. Both Kara and I have changed our game plan a lot recently. We both went from very well-rounded guard players, top players. I was very proud of us both to see a large amount of wrestling, a lot of work on the feet, even if not too many attempts went to the ground, even the positional battles were. For me, it's good to see the Australian grappling's growing and I'm not getting left behind.
Ricky, what impressed me most was your decision-making. Every time you found yourself under pressure, every time you found yourself under stress, you were cool under pressure, you made the right decisions, you managed to get back up, and at the end, you went on the attack, and I was so impressed by the aggression you showed there. Would you have done anything different in that match if you had the chance to do it again?
Man, maybe more. Gaia's guard is really scary, so I guess I hesitated a little bit, worried about the leg injuries. Maybe if I just did a bit more headbutting, a little more of what I did on the standing, just driving into him, keeping a bit more pressure, I might have been able to hold the pin and work better from there. But other than that, man, I'm gassed. I hope he's gassed. And man, that was about all I could give.
Bro, I'm gassed from watching that fight. Never mind you being gassed. So is there a message that you want to give to your family, your friends, your people watching on right now?
Man, thanks everybody so much. There's a very long list. My little GB crew from Perth over there. Thanks so much, guys. My GB crew from Bondi, Sydney came all the way through. My professor, is this the main camera?
That's the main camera.
Everybody watching at home that helped me train, the 20-minute rounds, the rolls. Guys, thank you all so much. We came, we did the best we could, and we're all happy now.
Ladies and gentlemen, before you leave, give it up for the man, Ricky Bashung. I am here with the 90-kilogram champion. Everybody, first and foremost, give it up for your new champion, Kai Rudolph. Kai, that was a fabulous matchup from start to finish. You showed your technical prowess from start to finish. Some of your guard work, some of your retention stuff was absolutely unbelievable. Talk us through how you prepared for today.
Honestly, I just did a lot of 20-minute rounds. I want to just thank Bruno for really helping me out there. And same with Sean Shipton, he fought earlier tonight. And he's just been killing me.
That front headlock position was a thing of beauty. Your snap down, the work that you did off the top of that was really, really impressive. Is that something you try to enact in when, you know, when you're competing at this professional level?
It's something I'm trying to work on a bit more. Ricky's obviously really hard to submit. Like, he'll let his shit break, so I knew joint locks weren't going to work. So I'd either have to put him to sleep. But trying to do that, my arms are gassed.
The submission attempt was amazing. You know, you did all the right things. And what I was saying to Ricky before is under pressure, he made the right decisions, which made that match really, really difficult for you. But you're standing here, the new battleground, 90-kilogram champion. Is there a message that you want to give to your friends, your family, the people watching at home?
I just want to thank George and the whole Battlegrounds crew. Like, this event was amazing. It's the best production I've seen in Australia so far. And it's really elevating the jiu-jitsu scene here in Perth and all in Australia as well.
Thank you very much. The King has spoken. We will be back for Battleground 6. We hope to see you all here. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your new 90-kilogram champion, Kai Rudolph.